Hello, hello. My name is Andre, and welcome to another Border0 demo. Today we're talking about SSH and how you can use your single sign-on credentials and Border0 to access all of your SSH servers. We're going to do a quick demo in a minute, and I'll show you how easy it is, and you can try this at home and follow along. But before that, a quick introduction. Many of you have SSH servers. Like, this is how we manage all of our infrastructure nowadays, whether these are servers, network devices, containers, it's used everywhere. And it's pretty well understood. So most of us log in to SSH using public-private key pairs, right? So we upload the public key on the server. You need to distribute this around, and then you can log in, assuming you have access to the private key. So this works great. Some of you still use passwords. That's really not that good. But also with the public-private keys, you need to distribute all these keys around. What happens if you lose one or it gets compromised? Would you even know? And can you rotate these things? So that's one of the challenges. The other challenge, what we're also looking at in this example, is the VPN type use case, right? So maybe you need to access something that sits behind NAT. So for example, your Raspberry Pi at home, or maybe it's a private server in your data center, or as more and more of us have SSH servers in, say, the Google clouds or the Amazon clouds, and typically behind a private VPC. Well, why do we do that? Well, let's take a look at this example server that I spun up about an hour ago or so. And if you do this, just take a look. So within the last, 20 minutes or so, I see like 15 failed logins, right? And you've all seen this. This is what happens. These are just scanners. And so that's just a fact of life, unfortunately. So what we do is we need to at least firewall this off from the internet. Well, then we need to start poking holes. Ideally, we just drop it in a private network, but then we have the challenge of not being able to log in. We have to use VPNs, but then I need to change VPNs all day long, which creates friction. And also just using VPNs, like you say, hey, if you come from this trusted IP, you have access. It's kind of an outdated model. And those of you who follow sort of the zero trust stuff, so what you really want is authenticate every single session over and over and check, is this the identity that has access? Is the posture still up to date, etc. So that's what we're going to talk about. So what we really want using Border0, we're going to achieve that, is being able to log into SSH servers using just your single sign-on credentials, no need for a VPN. And as an administrator, and we'll see that in a bit, I want to see exactly who accessed what. I want to control this with rich policies, and I even want to see exactly what happened during those sessions. So that's the quick 3-minute intro. Let's just now dive right into the actual demo. So if you want to follow along, I have a test server and I'm going to install Border0 on that using this install script. So what happens here is, let me quickly log in. It downloads some of the dependencies. It asks me to log in to the dashboard. Then it downloads an API token. It created a Border0 SSH service in our platform, and it wired it up and it dials out to our infrastructure and created some of the systemd units. So the result here now is that I have a systemd unit that runs a custom sort of SSH binary that we make available. Unlike your normal SSH server, this doesn't actually listen on a TCP port. It doesn't listen on a network socket. It actually only listens on what we call the Border0 tunnel, the outbound tunnel. So that means that those scans that we just saw happening with all the brute force attacks, they are not possible. And since it's an outbound tunnel, this is also what enables us to make this available from behind NAT, right? So this server can sit in a private VPC or on my laptop behind NAT. It will still be able to access inbound connections, but only through Border0. So you already hugely reduced your attack surface. All right, so now let's take a look at the logs. I'll open up the logs here. So that was it. That was pretty easy to get going. So now let's try and log in. So now we're changing persona. I'm an engineer. I'm trying to log in to one of our servers. So the first thing I'll do is do a demo, a login. So we'll demo the login to an organization. Let me just pull up this incognito window. So I want to show the SSO flow. So I have logged out here. So let me just do a fresh login. I'll log in with my Gmail. And So I just want to show you the SSO flow. You're familiar with this. Okay, it's asking me to do MFA. We're secure. Yes, this is me. Great. So now I've logged in. And now I have access to everything in this organization. So using this command, I can ask for all the SSH instances I have access to. So as an engineer, I instantly can just discover what I have access to. So I'll click on the one that I want to connect to, the one that we just created. You can see that here. You see, hey, atunk@gmail has just logged in. You can just do whatever. This is a normal SSH session. One of the differences is you could see that this user logged in through the Border0 platform. So that's powerful. And then we'll just run top or whatever we were here to do. I can also use the regular OpenSSH client if you're used to that. We can do that. There's some documentation about that. Or you can use the Border0 desktop app, which again similarly allows you to discover all the services that you're having access to and then quickly connect there as well. So that's it. So that was pretty easy as an admin or as a user. So now we go back to the administrator portal. So what we want to see is all of the sessions. So let me log in here. So these are all the sessions. So you can kind of see this is kind of like a firewall log, right? So let me first kill this session. So you can see this one's still live. So let me kill this and you should be able to see here. Yeah, I was instantly kicked out. So this is real time. So you can really think of this sort of as a real time firewall log, but unlike just ports and protocols and IP addresses, you actually have identity. You can see that I logged in as user root, the IP address I came from, etc. So now I can also, as an administrator, replay this session. So that's pretty powerful for, you know, troubleshooting or security purposes. You can see the window is exactly the same size, the speed is the same. So we're literally watching back a movie of exactly what happened. Now, other than that, we also should take a quick look at the policies. So a policy is attached to one or more services in Border0. So we have different views. Let's take a look at the JSON view. Most of you are geeks, so I enjoy that. So a bunch of actions in the policy. So what can you do under which conditions? So typically between which dates or time of day, from which IP addresses or which country should I not be in? And then also obviously identity. So if you authenticate as anyone with a Border0.com account or specifically atunk@gmail.com, those all have access. So that was a quick demo. Hopefully that kind of gave you an idea of what's possible. Just to wrap up, we looked at how we can make SSH services available through the Border0 platform. If your SSH server runs in a private VPC or a private network, that's all okay. We can still make that work. You don't need a VPN, so it's very low friction. As an engineer, I had access, sort of an inventory of what I have access to according to my identity. So that's really powerful. It was really easy to access to it. And again, then as the administrator, we saw all the sessions, I could review the sessions, I could kill them, and I was able to set up custom policies. So I think this is a pretty powerful set of features. I hope you're this piqued your interest. And we encourage you to give this a try yourself. We have a free edition you can start it with. If you just follow the instructions on this blog or our documentation, you should be able to get going within 1 or 2 minutes. And let us know how it goes. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. We're always there to help. Thanks for joining. Talk to you later.